That's better.
Number 7, Dawson Allberg. Batting fourth, first baseman number 33,
we're live.
Helenis. Batting fifth, the center fielder number 13,
it's Tanner way better.
Batting sixth,
put
the
pitcher
number
put
six,
in the bucket.
Andrew Meldrew.
Sure he did.
And there's a, you know, sound yeah. coming this way.
Batting seventh, second baseman number 2, Owen Blomfeldt. Batting eighth, the catcher number 5, Evan Blomfeldt.
That'd be good. That's good.
And batting ninth, the right fielder number 4, Tucker Fisher-Burth.
Big time in it.
And the rest of the Superior Spartans. Now here's the starting lineup.
Look at that, it's good. Might have discovered something.
Left fielder number 9, Austin
in the bucket, keep the wind out, but get the sound
coming. Batting second, second baseman number 5, Ben Johnson.
And the sound kind of, the bucket makes it be a funnel.
Batting third, catcher number 11, Chase McQuaid.
It's a lot of good stuff going on there.
Batting fourth, shortstop number 6, Kate Mueller. Batting fifth, right fielder number 20, Henry Zimmerman. Batting sixth, first baseman number 8, Cody Olson.
Yeah.
Batting seventh, the designated hitter number 10, Ty Manadin. Batting eighth, the third baseman number 2, Chase Rudolph. Batting ninth, center fielder number 13, Bryce Bevin. And the starting pitcher for the Wildcats today is number 12, Auden Penkinen. And the rest of the Wildcats. At this time, we ask that everyone please rise, remove your headwear, and face the flags in left center field for the playing of the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming. Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Wildcat Baseball here on the River Falls Sports YouTube Network. I'm Kevin Westhouse, joined by Gregory Eugene Peters to bring you some Wildcat Baseball action this afternoon. It's the River Falls Wildcats taking on the Superior Spartans, coming off of Lake Gitchagumi, coming on down to Highway 35 to River Falls, Wisconsin for some spring baseball. Hey, Greg, how are you?
Kevin, I'm doing just fine. I tell you what.
Put that up to your mouth, Steve.
When Steve Manford plays Steve Bones, River Falls resident plays the anthem, it just gets you fired up.
It gets you fired up. A few goosebumps on the back. That's River Falls' very own.
Steve Bones.
If you could have heard him, he used to be for the Minnesota Wild hockey games.
He did. He sang the anthem live for the Wild all the time.
Guy's the real deal right here, right in our own. Bring it right into your living room. Hey, on the mound today for the River Falls Wildcats, Auden Penkinen, the big lanky right-hander, throws in the low 90s. It'd be fun to watch him for a couple innings today, Greg.
Yeah, he's got a live arm. There is no doubt about that. He was had a little back injury, nothing major, but had a, I think it was like a pars fracture.
Uh-huh.
And he had kind of that over the fall and the winter.
Uh-huh.
But I think he's all healed up, and you can see it right there on your screen. He brings it. There is no question about that.
Oh, yeah. So one more day tomorrow morning, Greg. Our Arnfield cameras get installed. So we're going to do it Wednesday, but not. The lifter operator said no one's going up in that 35-foot lift in 45 mile an hour winds.
No,
he said his insurance didn't cover that.
Kenny the Thrill Phil is He is a Superman, but everybody has their
limitations.
Everybody's limited. That 45-mile-per-hour winds is the thrill's kryptonite.
It is. So tomorrow he's taking off work tomorrow, and he's going to take a paid time off day, and we're hiring him to come out here and put up the cameras for us.
The thrill.
So here we go. Calvin Anderson leading off. It'll be Calvin Anderson, Jace Rue, and Dustin Allberg.
Switch sides.
Yeah, here. Dustin top. There we go. And Dawson Allberg for the top three here for the Superior Spartans.
You can see the wind whipping on Calvin's pant leg.
It's whipping today. It's coming pretty good. So here we go. Just about ready for first pitch here. Pretty prompt. Are we even early today? Look out, ball one. What time do you have? I've got 3:56. We're early today.
We're 4 minutes ahead of schedule.
There is going to be a mad mom somewhere. Is going to be. Why do they start early? We're going to hear. All right, the one ball pitch. That's a little jam sandwich into left field. Left fielder coming in. Oh, and then just drops in there. Got him in on the fist, just muscles that out over the outstretched arms of Caden Mueller at shortstop, and Calvin Anderson garners himself a leadoff single.
18, one thing I'm going to do, Kevin, from our Tuesday venture here, is I'm not going to keep the pitch count because Steve keeps it better than me anyway.
Yeah, and then we'll just repeat it.
And that
we'll just fill you in every now and then.
Yeah.
So Jace Rue, the shortstop, and he bunts one up here back towards the backstop. Jason McQuaid giving that a good chase, along with third baseman Chase Rudolph. So a couple chases chasing it down, Greg.
Yeah, absolutely. There, you know, one of the things, too, is I think in the early going, I don't, you know, we could, but I don't think we're going to, that 100 pitch count per pitcher is going to really matter here in the early going, because I think they pitch a few innings and then they getting kids up to speed on the getting their arms strengthened.
The one strike pitch, that's popping the leather, just misses offside. Now it's 1-1 to shortstop Jace Rue. Calvin Anderson saw a ball. He took the next pitch off the grip tape and flipped it into left field for a leadoff single. That one's right down Hanson Drive, and it's 1-2.
Boy, Auden Pankinen tipped the radar gun at 92 right there.
Popping the leather. Chase McQuaid with a little thicker glove on the catch hand today. Underneath the leather glove. The pitch. How about some cheese upstairs? And Chase McQuaid with a little back pick action down to first base. Cody Olson trying to apply the tag. He won't get it, but gets the strikeout. There is one down, Greg. And now we're going to go to Dawson Allberg, the left fielder, with one out.
Well, one thing with Auden last year as a sophomore, he's a junior this year. Last year as a sophomore, he did battle some control problems here and there. Nothing major, but boy, he is painting the outside black part of that plate right there.
He is right now just throwing aspirins right here, Greg.
Yeah, I think we're gonna use a few of those names today on the pitching side.
Yeah, we will.
That was a little slider, just a bit outside.
A little slide piece. I've got something for you. Would you go grab that manila envelope? That's for you on top of that thing right down there. Let's grab that manila envelope, Brian. That's from work. Some work stuff for you.
We're going to pull the old Bob Uecker deal.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to go until 5, and then I got to head over to Menominee for work, okay. And then Brian McQuaid's going to step in.
So, Brian McQuaid, you've got the fifth inning and on tonight, okay?
There's another strikeout.
I can't wait.
There's another strikeout via Auden Pankinen's right lightning bolt arm.
Dawson Allberg goes down via the strikeout. Now we go to Hudson Hellenius, and I'm going to put Hudson Hellenius on the honorable mention all names team. That's pretty good right out of the chute.
He right out of the gate.
Hudson Hellenius. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly.
If there's any Superior parents watching or fans watching from Superior, and you know if we're mispronouncing some names, let us know in the chat section.
Let us know. Just get up in the chat section and say hello. We do like to give shout-outs, get people engaged. One ball and no strikes on four-hole hitter Hudson Hellenius. Runner goes. Chase McQuaid throw down. That is an absolute C down to second base. And Chase McQuaid, the future college athlete, throws out Calvin Anderson on a beautiful throwdown. And that one's just going to go 2-6 for out number 3, And that will do it for the Superior Spartans here in the top of inning one. Spartans send three to the plate. They get a leadoff single off the bat of Calvin Henderson, but they garner no runs on the one hit, no errors, and none left. One half inning in the books from First National Bank of River Falls Field in River Falls, Wisconsin. Superior Spartans nothing, and your River Falls Wildcats coming to bat.
Boy, that was a quick release from Chase McQuaid.
Jeez, he got that thing, and bam, bam, wasn't it?
It's going to be tough to steal today when you got a 90-mile-per-hour fastball coming in from the mound and then a quick catcher with a great arm throwing down. I mean, I think that throw out at second base pretty much told the Superior coach, like, yeah, we might not be stealing any bases today.
Yeah. So all I got to say about that is, hey, Colton Nesbitt. Nezzy, welcome aboard.
Big Colton. He made the broadcast last Tuesday. He was here in the stands watching, and we gave him a shout-out.
There you go.
Because when I saw him in January, he was about 6'1 or so, and then I see him in March, and he's about 6'5.
So I have to give a shout-out to Greg Peters right here. A little bit of broadcast verite that's going to go unnoticed. We've got great audio tonight. He's got our on-field mic in a bucket so it doesn't get the wind.
Protects the wind a little bit.
It's sounding great, Greg.
Well, that's good.
Nice work. Nice work.
You know what they say, the sun shines on a dog's rear end every once in a while.
You know, it'd be better on the net right behind the batter, yeah. but this is, considering how windy it is, it's pretty good.
I can probably move that bucket down there on the...
Let's not get greedy now.
All right, okay.
Let's not get greedy now.
It does pick up Steve's music a lot better.
And the lineups and all that, so that's better. Yeah. So better than having nothing. How about that?
You get to hear Steve Manfred a little better, get to hear some tunes a little better.
I got the heat going again for you over here today.
I like it.
It's not quite as bad as the other.
No, it's way better today.
All right, we're going to go Austin Curdy, Ben Johnson, Chase McQuaid. Then it'll be Caden Mueller, Henry Zimmerman, Cody Olson. Then Ty Mannanen, Chase Rudolph, and Bryce Bevin. Curdy, Johnson, McQuaid, Mueller, Zimmerman, Olson, Mannanen, Rudolph, and Bevin. And here we go. Mel George on the mound. The lefty flips one in there. And Austin Curdy fouls that off over the Liney's Lodge. And it's 0-1 now on left fielder, leadoff batter, Austin Curdy.
Say Ty Mannanen about 10 times in a row. That's tough to say.
I had a tongue twister, Ty Mannanen. The 0-1 pitch, the lefty delivers. That's upstairs. Now it's 1-1. Hey, Grayson. Said, yep, go Cats. Yep, cabbage, he says. He didn't say that, but I just said that was a Brett Favre. Little yep, cabbage.
right back. That would have hit me in the head if that net wasn't there.
It would have been right in your chili. It's 1-2 now on Austin Curdy.
Oh, it's quite, compared to Tuesday, it's balmy out today.
This isn't bad. The pitch, that's up and high and tight. Now 2-2. Yeah, Andrew Melgeorge, he's got the pants up high. Got the long light blue sanitaries way up there. Flipped up left side.
Kind of has a Ron Guidry motion.
A little bit of a Guidry thing going on.
Louisiana Lightning.
It's fouled up and out of play. Has what he likes from his battery mate, Evan Blomfelt, the pitch. Look out. It's now 3-2. Nice leadoff at bat here for Austin Curdy, making Andrew Melgeorge throw a lot of pitches. Seeing some pitches, making him work. Nice leadoff at bat. Put a Q next to this no matter what happens. It's quality. And it get the walk.
Well, speaking of the Superior Duluth area, Kevin, well, you can announce this next batter, and then I'll tell you the story.
Number 5, Ben Second baseman Ben Johnson, go ahead.
We got to put a guy in first there, too, and there he is. All right. There was a good friend of mine, and I were big fans of Gordon Lightfoot, so we were going to drive over across the border to Canada to go see a concert. We figured he was kind of getting near the end. He was in his 80s, and we weren't allowed in the country because of the, you know, because of COVID stuff. And then Gordon Lightfoot passed away, but, Gordon Lightfoot's The Wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald up by Duluth and Superior. That's one of the better songs written of all time.
So, Greg, usually when we play Superior, I come in with that song.
Well, it would have been.
I usually do it today.
You verbally came in with it a little bit.
Yeah, so typically I do just because I I like the song, and I think it's appropriate. It's a nice tie-in.
Sure.
But I kind of ran out of time today and just didn't do it. I was lazy. How about that? If there's such a thing, throwback to first.
I think using the word lazy and you in the same sentence is...
I thought about it, though. I just didn't follow through.
What's the correct term for that? That would be a...
oxymoron?
Oxymoron. There you go.
I don't know. 2-0. 2-0 to Ben Johnson.
You read my mind. That's what I was looking for.
Nice fastball there in the inside corner. Ben Johnson swings through that, and it's 2-2. Bottom of the first, just underway. Glad you could join us. Kevin Westhouse, along with Greg Peters, bringing you the action. Greg will be here till inning 5, then he'll turn the reins over to Brian McQuaid.
Kind of got a little Milwaukee Brewer with Euchre coming in.
Just like that.
I have to head over to Menominee. Speaking of all the wind, we got a wind claim over in Menominee. I got to go check out.
Yeah, that's good. Someone's got to
go hop up on a roof.
Fun, Greg. Mel George stares into Blomfelt. Has with the left. Runner goes! Joe's bunt pulls it back, and that's going to be a stolen base for Austin Curdy. Boy, you really like Ben's motion there where he fakes bunt, pulls back in towards the catcher, creates just a little bit of havoc, a little interference, make it a little more difficult.
Yeah.
And helps with the stolen base there for Austin Curdy. Now a runner in scoring position with nobody out.
Baseball is definitely a game of inches, and every inch you can get is helpful for your team.
And now Ben Johnson gets himself the free pass, and it's runners at first and second with nobody out, and we're going to go to three-hole hitter Chase McQuaid. Good opportunity here now as we hit the middle of the lineup, the beef. See if Coach Bishop elects to go for the big inning here or maybe get one down and play for a run. I think he's more of a big inning guy.
Well, when the mic's on that side, you can hear it. We have some stands. There's a couple of people.
Yeah, we have the mic in a bucket next to a bunch of metal chairs on a cement
behind a sign.
Yeah.
Hiding it from the wind.
So you heard, that's what you were hearing there. That was not Greg with a nervous tummy.
No. Well, Mel George has been kind of living on that, I guess, for right-handers, that high and away spot. Look for him to kind of overcorrect and kind of get one right in the inside part of the plate for Chase to do something with right here.
The 2-0 popped up right side, first baseman giving chase near the stands. That's going to reach the seats up on the roof, and it's 2-1. Yeah, it's fun hitting 2-0 with runners at first and second and nobody out. You know, tough to hit the off switch on that. You know he's going to come.
And McQuaid was ready to take a rip at it.
Ready to go to ripping. Mel George set the 2-1 pitch. Another hit to right field. Right fielder not moving back a little bit. Now over to his right. Makes the catch. And runner's going to tag and go to third.
Uh-oh.
Now we got a hot box. Ball gets away. And the run will score for the Wildcats. So how about that? We had a sack fly. Well, I guess it wasn't going to be a sack, but the runners were going to tag in advance. And... runner was going to get to third. The runner between going to second got hung up. He got in a hot box. Superior threw it into the rhubarb, and Wildcat scored a run.
Let's see. We got to do a pop an error up there on the scoreboard.
So McQuaid with an F9, one out. We go to Caden Mueller.
It was an E4 that scored the run. That was a
hit. That's a left. That's down. That's into the corner. Here comes a runner around third. He'll score. Caden Mueller cruises on into second base with a stand-up double. Just an absolute flush rocket out into the left field corner, Greg.
That was struck well. That thing got out to the fence in about a half a second.
The Wildcats jump out to a quick 2-0 lead.
Yeah, so that was Caden Mueller. So this is – sorry about that, folks. That was Caden Mueller that just hit that. I got Henry Zimmerman up now on the
Henry's
scoreboard.
Up. We got him right in his scorebook.
I Mel George hits the outside part of the plate for strike one.
0-1 now on five-hole hitter Henry Zimmerman, the right fielder. He's a tall drink of water. Just down, now 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out.
That was a good place to miss if you're Mel George on the mound. He went outside, went inside, just a couple inches inside, but a good location there, 0-1.
Popped up, right side again. First baseman giving chase. He's going to run out of real estate over there. And just a long foul strike. It's 1-2.
Well, I always like to watch these when the pitchers in the first inning and stuff and see what pitchers are going to throw here when it's, you know, when they're ahead in the count, you know, 1-2, and you can kind of get a sort of your game plan for your plate approach when you go for the rest of the game here.
2-2. There is one out, Greg.
Oh, whoops, sorry. Thanks. Yeah.
Oh, old Uncle Charlie just misses there. Now 3-2. Nice curveball off the arm of Mel George. Just couldn't quite find the corner. Chopper left side. Shortstop gathers it onto first. High throw, but just got him.
But, yeah, that's some of the things when you look there, Kevin. Like, you see what a pitcher's going to throw, you know, when he's ahead in the count, and then you also watch and see what the guy's throwing when he has to throw a strike.
Yes.
What pitch is he most confident in, so you start to get your plate approach ready for the, you know, the remainder of the game.
So now we're going to go to Cody Olson. Hey, my mother is tuned in from Waupun, Wisconsin. She says, hey, no snow on the ground up there. They got snow down in Waupun.
They do.
Oh, yeah, they got a lot of snow down in southeast Wisconsin. Not here.
Hello, Mrs. Westhouse.
See, there you go. Yeah, no snow here. It's mid-40s today. We just barely got it. We didn't even get a skiff,
the
really.
Temperature on the on Jenna's car on the way over here said it was 50.
Wow, geez. The wind maybe makes it feel a little bit cooler. And Cody Olson swings through that. Now it's 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs. Two in for the Wildcats. Runner at third. There's still one out there for first baseman Cody Olson. See if he can get one through here with two in the bucket. The pitch. Excuse me. That was just strike two. Got a little eager there on the outside corner. It's 1-2.
I think the umpire thought it was strike three for a second there, too.
Right. We all flinched on that.
He was a little dramatic on that strike.
Maybe that's why I was looking at his punch out.
He was dramatic on
that. Oh, nice job. Cody Olson shoots that through on the left side. Little oppo taco there for Cody Olson. Two out RBI single for the Olson kid. Nice piece of hitting there.
Great piece of hitting by Cody Olson. That ball was on the outside part of the plate. He just dropped the hands, laid the barrel right on the ball, and
Tony Gwynn did.
Yep, just shot it right through the hole on the left side.
Really nice. Pretty good piece of hitting. 3-0 Wildcats. Now we're at Ty Manninen. Ty Manninen's the DH today for River Falls.
And that's what you go ahead.
That's hit towards center field. Center field going back. He's not going to get that. That's in the gap. That's almost all the way to the wall. Now cutoff runner coming around third. They got him coming in, and he scores. Cody Olson. Another two-out RBI. This time it's Ty Manninen with a two-out RBI double. Scores Cody Olson all the way from first base. The beauty of that right there, Greg, with two outs, as soon as that ball struck, Cody Olson can be off to the races.
Yep.
So it's a little easier to score from first with the two outs there.
Absolutely. He was running right on contact.
Now we go to Chase Rudolph, the third baseman. Eighth batter to bat this inning for River Falls. That's up and away. Now one ball and no strikes.
And you and I would have been puking coming around third, but he ran his three 90-foot sprints with no trouble at all.
They would have been yelling at me, unhook the plow.
Me too.
That's hit towards center field. Center fielder coming in, still coming, and gets down, sliding, and makes the catch. Nice job out there in center field.
Tanner Lino.
Tanner
Leno.
Hey, Leno. Tanner Leno makes the running sliding catch on pretty well-struck ball by Rudolph. I'm going to give that a line out to center, and that will do it. Wildcats scored three runs on three hits. There was one error and one left. After one inning in the books now from First National Bank of River Falls Field, it is the River Falls Wildcats 3, the Superior Spartans 0.
I tell you what, this is very enjoyable.
Isn't it fun?
Sun's out.
Guns out.
We're in the press box, so it's a little warm. It's warmer here with a heater.
And I'm hovered over a heater.
This is so much better. This is fun. Girls softball has a big doubleheader today up in New Richmond.
Oh, yes.
We got to talk to the girls last night. Kevin, once again, Thanks for helping out with the preseason coaches. You know, so I know the girls and the parents liked it a lot, I know.
We've done a lot of these coaches shows. I'm going to say that was the best one we ever did. The girls and you and the coaches made it a fabulous show.
Well, I didn't really do too much. It was the coaches and the players were good. And it was technically, I think it was a Tubi or an Emmy.
Emmy.
You had two cameras going. The lighting was good. The audio was good. You did a solid job.
Well, the girls did great. The coaches did great. I don't know. Those always seem to be a bigger hype than they actually are. But last night, it was the real deal. I mean, for those that get to watch the girls' softball coaching show, it was 20 minutes of pure enjoyment.
I think the people there watching liked it. They were clapping, had a good time.
Yeah. Hey, John Parsons. Yeah, he noticed that Cody was chucking it all the way from first to home. Yeah.
Is this Jace Root?
Hold on. Let me get hit this here. This is Hudson Hellenius because he was up last inning, and then they got the throw out. So he's back at it again. Fouls away at the plate. So, yeah, we're Hudson Hellenius.
There we go.
Because Hudson was batting when Calvin Anderson got thrown out by the stiff arm of Chase McQuaid. Swings through that little wrinkle on that one. Had him out in front. It's 0-2. The 0-2 pitch just comes back with some gas. Gets a piece of it, and we'll stick it 0-2. Auden Pankinen just pumping cheddar right now.
Look for a high fastball about shoulder high right here.
Zing! Oh, got it down a little bit into the zone. Probably a little bit too juicy for his liking. Got to get that up a little bit. But Hellenius had a tough time catching up with it. But nice job by him fouling that off up into the upper deck. The 0-2. Little slide piece there on the outside corner, maybe just a little bit.
Just a hair outside. That was a tough one to take right there with two strikes.
One ball and two strikes now. Shaking off signs is Auden Pankinen, and now he has what he likes. Chopper to third. Gathered. On to first. High throw. Tag.
Nice play at first.
Got him. Cody Olson playing his position well over there at first base. A high throw from third baseman Chase Rudolph. But up the ladder goes Cody Olson. He hauls it down and then tags Hellenius on the way by. That'll simply go as a 5-3 putout in the book, but it looked a lot better in person. Some good athleticism there.
Yeah, good play. Caught it. Made the tag.
Now we go.
No collision.
Now we go to Tanner Leno, high chopper to first.
Yeah.
And nice.
They called a foul ball.
I agree with that.
If he would have,
A late call, though.
Just a hair right of the bag.
A little bit of a late call, but I was watching it on the monitor. It looked a little foul to me. I wasn't watching the field. I was watching the monitor.
I think that was the right call the umpire made.
Mm-hmm. Pankinen, the high knee kick, and here he comes. 92 on the jugs gun there. It's 0-2. It had some giddy up on it, didn't it?
Yes, it did. That thing had some hair on it.
Whew. Pankinen waste no time, pitching like he's double parked. Fouls that away. It sticks at 0-2.
You're not going to see too many foul balls from right-handed hitters go down the left field side with Pankinen pitching.
I do not think so. Pankinen stares into McQuaid. Here he comes.
That slider was nasty. That was a nasty slider.
And that will produce what I like to call the old excuse me swing on that.
Andrew Melgeorge.
Not much Tanner Leno could do with that slide piece there. Two down. Tanner down via the strikeout. Now we go to Andrew Melgeorge with two in the bucket here in the top of frame two.
Yeah, on a chilly day like today, Chase McQuaid's got to have at least two batting gloves on underneath that catcher's mitt with,
right?
With Pankinen's.
Bringing it like
what
he
River
is.
Falls has had, you know, last year Keenan Mork was, yeah. he was touching high 80s, low 90s, and
yeah.
Pitching for Notre Dame this year.
Yes, and now we've got Auden Pankinen.
He's just a junior, and looking at his frame and stuff and, mm-hmm. and his age and all that, he's probably going to get a little bigger for sure.
He's got the look, yeah. Doesn't he?
I think he's got a couple more inches in him and, you know, put on some weight and some pounds when you get kind of your man strength and stuff, mm-hmm. and he's going to be throwing untouchable heat next year for sure.
Pankinen now falls behind to Andrew Melgeorge. Pitcher against pitcher here. I tell you what, Andrew Melgeorge has been doing some toe lifts. Look at the calves on that kid. Baby calves below the knees. Another little slider. It's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Twos are wild right now. Cheddar, what do you think? Bring it upstairs.
Yeah, he's going to go fastball right here.
Tries to paint the corner, and he does. And that will do it. Auden Pankinen, strikeout looking on Mr. Andrew Melgeorge, and a couple strikeouts for Auden Pankinen. And the Superior Spartans send three to the plate. They get no runs on no hits, no errors, and none left. Two strikeouts in the inning for Pankinen. After an inning and a half of play now, it is the Wildcats 4, the Spartans nothing.
Pankinen looking dominant on the mound for the Wildcats so far in the early going, in first two innings.
Total command. I wonder if Coach Bishop will let him go another.
Oh, I would have stretched him out a little bit, I guess.
They're talking about it now. I think in the pregame he came up here and said maybe just a couple innings, so we'll see. Pitch count's pretty low, though.
How many pitches does he have, Steve?
I'm going to guess 24.
What was it? 27, I think.
Ooh,
he said.
That's close.
Very close. But, I mean, even getting 50, 55, I mean, that's just like a bullpen session.
Right. I want to see him go one more. He's just kind of fun to watch. So if you're looking ahead to the River Falls Wildcat, bottom of frame two, we're going to go 9-1-2. Bryce Bevin, Austin Curdy, and then Ben Johnson.
Speaking of radioactive, that's what Pankinen's fastball's been today.
I saw the other day, we had over 1,000 viewers on the game the other day.
Jeez.
It's pretty good for baseball.
Everybody's ready to watch some baseball.
Baseball, I guess. It's a good number for high school baseball.
And they probably weren't quite ready to come out to watch the game when it was,
right.
was 36 and windy.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Center fielder Bryce Bevin makes his way to the dish. And we're set to go here. And Bevin looks at a ball upstairs. One ball and no strikes. In the bottom of inning two, Wildcats tacked up, put up four in frame one on three hits, and there was an error. Fouled away, 1-1. Superior's probably not had a bad spring for baseball practice, so either I was up there for basketball in February, and there was no snow in Superior, not even a pile.
They got a bunch when we had that 2-3 inches, you know, what was it, last week?
Oh, yeah.
They got dumped on last week because I have a nephew that goes to Duluth, and he told me they had about 2 feet of snow up there.
A lot of gym practices then for this team. Maybe their first time on the field, probably. Spring ball in Wisconsin. It's kind of an iffy thing. Another one flipped up, foul, not a play. Almost an instant replay of the play before, and it's 1-2. I was going to say crapshoot. I don't know if I can say that, but I think I can.
I think you can. Well, it's like it's a game. Right. It's a dice game.
Right. High chopper, left side. Going to be a tough play. Gather. See if you can beat it out.
Nice play.
Got him. That's third baseman over there.
Calvin Anderson.
Yeah. Calvin got that at a high hop. I knew it was going to be close, and then Calvin throws a dart and gets Bryce Bevan on a 5-3 ground out. There's one down. We're going to go back to the top of the order now to Austin Curdy. Austin Curdy, he walked and scored in the first. Grounder to second. Gathered, Curdy's hustling, and nice play out there by second baseman Owen Blomfelt.
Yeah, Owen Blomfelt stayed down on that ground ball very nicely.
Now, second baseman number 5, Ben Johnson.
Now, quickly with two outs, we're going to go to two-hole hitter and second baseman Ben Johnson. Sun kind of in and out here this afternoon at First National Bank of River Falls Field. Just an absolute beautiful, pristine facility here in River Falls, Wisconsin. Not only good for high school baseball, this would be good for professional baseball. Beautiful park.
Umpire had that curveball a little high. That was
Thought it might have dropped in there. Superior fans are just screaming at their televisions right now. That looked good. The 1-0. 2-0. We're in the second. It's 4-0 River Falls. River Falls capitalized on two early walks. Both of them scored. The 2-0.
They did all that with two outs, didn't they, with at least the hits anyway.
The single and the double, all with two outs. Yes. I think they scored one with less than two. Three of the four were with two outs. Three balls and a strike. Should Ben Johnson reach, Chase McQuaid waits on deck. The 3-1. Fouled up. Out of play. There's a bunch of them over there.
Boy, when Mel George, you know, it's you know, early in the season, but when he gets a little overstrides a little bit with his right leg, and he's high and outside, you know, all the time, and when he gets in that groove and he gets his front step going down, then he's right there. Got a good little curveball too.
So Ben Johnson garners his second walk of the game, and now we're going to go to Chase McQuaid.
The catcher, number 11, Chase McQuaid.
Chase McQuaid flew out to right field his first time up. Fairly deep fly ball. It was deep enough for runners to tag on, and then a run scored on the throwing error in that sequence allowed Austin Curdy to come home. Down and inside, ball one. Runner at first. There's two in the bucket.
Might want to look for a steal right here.
Maybe. One ball and no strikes.
Get Curdy on in scoring position for McQuaid to drive him in.
Like it. Fouled away at the plate. Now it's 1-1.
Or Johnson, excuse me. Yeah, Ben Johnson. Yeah, Curdy grounded out the second. That's right. I have the roster. I wish I had the... We'll fix that next game.
Oh, in front of you?
Yeah, we have it.
Oh, that's flowing up. Center field. Center fielder battling the sun, going back a little bit. Now he's camped under it and makes the one-handed catch in medium deep right center field, and that will do it for the Wildcats here
in
the bottom of inning two. No runs, no hits. There's one left. Two in the books. It's 4-0 River Falls.
Yeah, it looks like Pankinen's coming out for inning number 3 here.
Oh, good. I'm selfish because I like watching him pitch. So how about that? Yeah, I want to welcome everybody aboard. If you want to get up on the chat section and say hello, well, let's say hello back to you. Nice afternoon for baseball.
Andrew Meldrew settled down there, had a good bottom of the second inning for Superior. Surprising when you throw strikes, what happens?
Yeah, look at the coach. That Superior coach. If you ever seen a baseball coach that coaches in Superior, he's got the gear right there. That guy.
He's got choppers on and a parka.
That is probably like game day normal attire up there in Superior. That's not even special order in Superior. You just put those right in with a uniform bag. the Skidoo Parka.
And the Choppers.
The Choppers. Look at that's a great look. Nothing says superior baseball more than that look right there. It's not that cold today, but he's ready.
I guarantee he's not cold.
No. Oh, no. You know, he's not. That's about practicality, right? That says practical. I'm warm. You guys, you're cold. You don't care how it looks. He's, I'm comfortable.
You know, that dress right there is equal to Rob Derry's comment when the girls come out in volleyball and they're wearing messy buns, messy hair buns.
Oh, yeah.
They don't care what their hair looks like. They're just coming out to just pound you. Just,
right. This guy says, hey, I'm warm. You're cold. It's on you. All right, here we go. Top of the third, 7-8-9 due up. Blomfelt, and Tucker Frazier-Berth. Gassed him up, just missed ball one.
Kevin, I like that scoreboard you concocted on the screen there. That's solid.
It's covering it, isn't it? Like, if you're just a viewer at home, and it really helps you kind of stay abreast of what's going on.
Especially when you're, you know, if you're one of the players or parents or something or relative, and you're trying to back after the game's done, and you're going back to look at it, and you want to check out a certain pitch or a hit or whatever. You know, it tells you right where you're at in the game.
I think it was NCAA basketball tournament, maybe, after this pitch. I'll tell you this story, the 3-1. Ooh. Now it's 2-2. They were saying goodbye to one of the producers in the truck, and her job was scoreboard controller, 30 years with NBC Sports, and that's all she did. What you're doing right now, probably for $110,000 a year, Greg.
Yeah.
Your job today, Mr. Volunteer, swings through that. It's a strikeout. Yeah,
you'd actually be surprised how little some of those guys make.
Yeah, maybe
the big name Jim Nance's make a ton, but
but she's probably a union job in the control booth. They probably pay decent.
Yeah, they can pay them. They can put food on the table.
But you're right though on the announcer deal, it's either feast or famine in the announcer world.
Yeah,
right. There's not much in the middle.
Nope. There's so few jobs at that level.
Right. But I was talking about camera operators, graphics people, scoreboard people. You know, they have 100 of them.
There's a guy that lives in River Falls named Dan Callinan that used to be a photog for the Twins, and it was back when it was like MSC, and then it was Fox Sports North, and then another guy I know named Tim DeFore. It just actually got out of it. He'd been doing it since he got out of college. So he's got to be 50, 51.
The 1-2 pitch flipped up, foul, and out of play.
He put a post on Facebook. He took his kid to a baseball game, and it was the first game he's ever been to with his kid because he's always working at him. And that's why he retired.
Ah, the 1-2 pitch, banking in waste. No time, little slide piece, misses his 2-2.
He was doing World Series and all kinds of stuff.
This is,
out in center field or with a camera doing that.
Yeah.
Doing the.
It's a pretty good gig. If you like watching sports and do your craft, right?
My best round of golf I've ever had in my entire life, I was golfing with Timmy DeFore up near St. Cloud State University.
That's funny. You wouldn't remember that. Pankin in rocks and delivers the full count pitch. That's away. And
boy, look how close the left fielder is over there.
Wow. Knows the wind. He says, you got to get into one to get one over my head. Tucker Frazier-Berthelm is up now. So you change your batter.
What?
Yeah, we're on Tucker Frazier. Runner at first. One in the bucket. Pankinen fires a ball just a little bit high.
That was 93 on the Jugs gun.
That thing had some hair on it, didn't it? Just a dart. The 1-0. Yeah, I mean, if this is your first game of the season, you're driving down from Superior, and all you've seen is short toss in the net in the gym, I bet that looks pretty quick coming this, in on
the,
you.
The 90 mile per hour fastball from Bankin, it looks like about 104.
Yeah. Like, what is that?
It's like Johan Duran.
Just throw you right into it. You get off the bus. You've been playing short toss for 2 weeks, and then you go face Auden Pankin in low 90s.
Yeah.
2-1. Now on Tucker. That paints the corner. Now 2-2. Going to be tough to do much with that. That was at the knees on the outside corner at 91.
Auden's younger sister, Amelie, was a rock star outside hitter for the Wildcat volleyball team that went to the state tournament this year. She was a freshman outside hitter. And she has some fast twitch muscles in her legs, too, just like Auden does in his arms, because that girl can get up.
A jumper. Jump right out of the gym. 3-2.
Her nickname is the Boom, because she brings it on the volleyball court.
That one is belt high.
Speaking of Boom.
Fastball, pumping cheddar right there. Another strikeout looking. There's two down now. We're going to go back to the top of the order to Kelvin Anderson. Kelvin led off this game with a little grip tape single into left, and then he was cut down trying to steal.
The only hit of the day for the Spartans. How many strikeouts did Pankinen have in that first nine?
He's got two strikeouts in each inning.
Okay.
So as far as two. So he has six strikeouts out of nine batters, Greg, if that's maybe a better way to say that.
That's what I was looking for.
Mm-hmm. Ball gets away, and runner goes down, and Evan Blomfelt will get into scoring position now with two outs.
I think you got to give that that's a pass ball, I think.
Yeah, PB.
Chase had his glove turned the wrong way on that one.
PB. Pass ball.
But Steve is the official score. He gave it a wild pitch.
Ooh.
Yeah, Chase had his glove like
inside
this
out,
instead of outside.
That's there now, 1-1. Pankinen set at the belt. Stares in, and here it comes. Away. That one's definitely a wild pitch there.
That's definitely a wild pitch.
And that one, and now Blomfelt all the way down to third. So runner at third now. There he stands with two outs. Superior looking to get on the board here in the top of inning three. A little softly hit, left side. That's going to be a real tough play. Swinging bunt. Safe all the way around.
Boy, Calvin Anderson has hit two balls that have traveled a total of about 100 feet, and he has two hits.
He's 2-for-2. And RBI on that one, too, Greg. So he scores Blomfelt from third. It's 4-1.
Now
we go to Jace Rue. Yeah, he had a little grip tape single over the shortstop's head, and then a swinging bunt. You couldn't have rolled out any better barehanded. Hats off to Calvin Anderson, 2-for-2 to start off the season. It doesn't matter, because game four, those look like frozen ropes in the
book.
When you look back on them. 1-B. Gassed him up. It's 1-1. Jace Rue struck out swinging his first time up today.
Yeah, you put the bat on the ball.
You never know.
Things can happen.
That's correct.
Well, and the other thing, too, that, Audnell, when you assess your game, it's the wild pitches. I mean, took the runner from first to third with not a lot of effort. Put him in position to score on that little duck snort. Isn't that what you call him?
Duck snort. Exactly. Could be a duck snort. What else we got? Clown punch. JP Fire hasn't put that one up there right there. Duck.
Yeah. Is JP,
he's with the Dodgers. Nope.
Is he up at the big club?
Yeah.
Or is he,
yep. Okay. He was. He was sent down.
Okay, yeah, okay. That's what I, okay.
3-2.
Probably needs a little bit of work just being off most of the year.
Exactly.
Last year.
Exactly. 3-2. Got him swinging. And Auden Pankinen rears back, and Jace Rue goes down swinging for out number three. But the Superior Spartans score a run. They get one run on the one hit, no errors, and one left. 2.5 in the books. It's 4-1 Wildcats. Might be a good time to verbally thank our main sponsor, First National Bank of River Falls. They're over there in Prescott. They're downtown River Falls, and they're on the campus of the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. First National Bank of River Falls, proud sponsors of everything Wildcat sport right here on the River Falls Sports YouTube network.
Well, I saw in the local paper online that First National Bank of River Falls business loan officer Bo Herstein was elected to the River Falls School Board recently.
Yes, good
along
for Bo.
With Alan Tuchtenhagen and Monica Lavolt. Last night when I was talking to you, Kevin, I had thought Crystal Dubois had edged Monica Lavolt, but I get that.
We were corrected.
But, yeah, I was looking at unofficial results. And
yeah.
It was a close race.
Real close. So hats off to Bo. He's one of our broadcasters on River Falls Sports YouTube network. We have a deep bench, and we often have to go to Bo, and he is solid.
He's always helped out on the PA for boys basketball games.
Yeah,
and
he's good.
Bo was the youth basketball, boys basketball president for many years.
He'll be good on the school board.
A little Caden Mueller action here.
We're going to go 4, 5, and 6. Caden Mueller, Henry Zimmerman, and Cody Olson do up for the Wildcats. Caden doubled and scored his first time up. Hit one in the gap in the right center. Excuse me. See the right center gap? I can't remember if it was him or
I think,
Ty Mannin. No, he ripped one down in the corner here, Greg.
That was a shot right off the 312 sign.
He did.
Right down the line.
Yeah, it was a frozen rope. Flush rocket, I think I called it.
You did.
The 2-0. 3-0, that's down. Andrew Melgeorge is falling behind of the leadoff batter, Caden Mueller here. He's hitting in the four spot today.
Yeah, Caden's got a great, the way he's, locked and loaded, where his stance up there, he looks like he's
ready.
Seeing the ball very well.
So Caden garners himself a leadoff free pass. Now we're going to go to Henry Zimmerman. Henry grounded out to shortstop, his first at bat today. Now we have a timeout and a conference on the mound. Head coach for Superior headed out for a little conference. I don't know if that'll be all for Melgeorge or not. It might be.
I don't have the head coach's name here, but he's out there kind of clapping his choppers together with those yellow gloves.
You don't get to say that phrase too often in a baseball game. He's clapping his choppers together. I got a pair of those choppers on the back porch. They are great for shoveling snow. Look at them.
And coaching baseball, apparently. I'm not getting on him at all.
No,
I'm
jealous. The guy's prepared.
Absolutely.
That's a prepared head coach right there. And Melgeorge is going to stay in the game. Chopper left side. Could be two to go to one on to first, and that's not going to be in time. They will get the lead runner there, and Zimmerman will reach on a fielder's choice. It's a 5-4 putout for out one. And now we're going to go to Cody Olson.
Cody Olson had a great at bat, last at bat when he, dropped hands down, hit it right through,
through
the hole between us. Short and third.
You're a lefty, Greg, and that is just a textbook lefty swing right there, isn't it?
Our coach that for the left-handers. I mean, that's. I'll just hit it where it's pitched.
Get
down,
ball.
Did it again.
That's a little clown punch right there into left center field for Cody Olson. He got that one out near the end of the bat.
Yeah, and that was a great pitch by Melgeorge. It was outside part of the plate. Great 0-0, great 0-0 pitch, and.
Just a better piece of hitting by very strong Cody Olson, able to muscle that out there.
Cody Olson just again threw the hands down, put the bat on the ball, and hit it right up, sort of right up the middle there.
Nothing fancy. So runners at first and second now with one down. We're going to Ty Mannin, who doubled. He hit one into right center his first time up and got that big two-out ribby. Ty Manon in the DH role today. Mel George set the pitch inside.
Well, I don't see anybody throwing in the bullpen either over there, so you're
nothing.
You might get one more.
That'd be fun.
And again, they're, you know, they might be just looking at pitch count too. So if he's
maybe
if he's he's sitting at 40, 45 pitches.
They said we're going to maybe 50 is his number today. What'd you say? 55, maybe 60 is the number then. I don't know. Or maybe he's done 3-0 to Ty. We're going to find out shortly. Ty Manon at 3-0.
What's the rule in high school baseball? How many
100.
How many innings do you have? Well, that I know, but how many innings do you have to pitch to get to be the official winning pitcher of record?
I don't know. Steve might. Turns inside, and Manon gets himself a one-out free pass, and that's going to load him up for Chase Rudolph.
The new batter is third baseman number two, Chase Rudolph.
We have to figure out how to reset the balls and strikes. There's got to be a way to do it.
There's got to be a way. There's got to be a way.
And it's fine. It's not. I mean, just hit the minus or plus.
I wonder, if you hit next to that bat, does that do it?
Maybe. Let me try something here.
Yeah, just play with it a second. New pitcher anyway. I'll get you a number.
Nope.
No?
Well, it does, but it does do that, but then it goes to the next guy.
Oh.
Which I don't.
This is number 21, Greg. 21 is coming to pitch for
us. Okay. Let's change that.
So, do you know who it is?
21. Number 21 is Lucas Androsky.
I've got him in here already, so you can narrow down over here. I put him on. There he is.
Right there. There's your pitcher, Lucas Androsky.
There he is.
Another lefty.
Hey, Scott Mann, Southeastern Tennessee, representing today in the house. Finally, busy day today. So let's go Wildcats.
Lucas Androsky had a heck of a bender right there. Oh, he's throwing curves left and right.
Brought out the backyard wiffle ball. He's going to be facing the eighth spot in the order in Chase Rudolph. That'll be with one out and bases loaded. He comes into the game in a pretty precarious spot here.
Bases full of cats.
Lucas Androsky.
How'd you like those Kitty City Energy t-shirts last night?
That was beautiful.
I'm not 100% sure who came up with that, but I think it was Mike Cayley and Rob Berry.
Yes, Kitty City.
I'm pretty sure it
was. The litter box in Kitty City. And they kind of embraced it.
Mike D and the artist Rob Berry started a revolution.
They embraced it. They embraced Kitty City.
Rob Derry's doing a heck of a job on the girls' soccer, too.
They've got a game tonight. So
yeah.
Marty and Rob will be bringing you that. The
I'm gonna have to
fever
check.
Pitch.
When I drive back from Menominee, I'm going to have to be
along
tuned,
with what's his name from Gospel Choir?
Josh Lassie.
Josh Lassie. That'll be bringing you the girls' soccer tonight. They got quite a team. One ball and no strikes.
Rumor has it they're recruiting Brian Jason Araski to come aboard next year because his daughter Jordan Sinaraski plays soccer and Lassie will be graduating.
Keep the farm system going. The pitch, that's high. Ooh, that thing about dropped in there, 2-0, just missed.
I think with just how many curveballs Lucas threw in his warm-up session, I think I would look curveball in the, you know.
Look out, that gets away from everybody, and run will score. So that's a wild pitch, and a run scores, Greg. That'll score Henry Zimmerman from third. Everybody else advances to second and third. And the count is 3-0 on Chase Rudolph. Walked him. And Rudolph on down to first, and we're going to load him back up now for Bryce Bevan, hitting in the nine spot today.
McQuaid knows how to do the scoreboard, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
I was going to say otherwise. Oh, yeah. I'll go get him. And
no, he knows how. Well, Ekball gets away as well, and run will score.
Boy, Cody Olson had a great jump. He was.
I think they might have been had a squeeze on there.
He had a great jump, and he was that thing hit the dirt, and he was already halfway home.
I think they had the squeeze on, and he just threw it away. Now we're going to go from the windup is Lucas Androwski, the pitch. That drops in there for a strike. It's 1-1. .59 hops in there. It's 2-1.
You have that up there.
I do.
Right there.
Right here, 59-footer. That might have been a 58-footer, Greg.
Let's see, we have there. One down.
Couple in for the Cats here in the bottom of inning three. They got something cooking. Nice job back there by Evan Blomfelt blocking that ball in the dirt. And he's going to take a timeout and go out and have a talk with Lucas Androwski. Look at Wildcat dugout. Look at them. They're all up, ready to go. They get new uniforms? Wildcats or not?
I mean.
They might have.
Maybe.
I don't know if I remember seeing the little, you know, piping on the sleeve there. You know, the little accent yellow.
We'll have to do some investigative reporting on that.
Right, yeah. It's a nice look. Kind of Milwaukee Brewers-ish looking, isn't it?
Yes.
That yacker finds the corner. It's now 3-2.
That scratched the outside part of the play.
Mm-hmm. Just 3-2.
Austin Curdy swings, has a little stance, kind of like Christian Yelich, speaking of the Brewers.
Mm-hmm. And he walked him. And
speaking of Curdy, here he comes.
So Bevan loads him back up, and we go back to the top of the order to Austin Curdy. So Austin Curdy, he's walked and scored, and he grounded out to second today. Now he's got a chance here with just one out, and the base is juiced. Just misses there. I'm with you, though. You got to be looking breaking ball here, I think.
Yeah, and sometimes the breaking ball pitch into a left-hander, too, they get around early on that, and you could hit one down in the corner there on the right field line.
Almost right on cue, but just foul. One and one, one ball, one strike, one out. Two in, bases loaded. We're at the top of the order in Austin Curdy. Hit right hard at second base. Second baseman gathers it, bobbles it. He'll wisely just get the out at first after the bobble. A run does plate for River Falls. That's Ty Manninen who scores there. And for the second time today, Austin Curdy grounds out to the second baseman. Two outs. Now we go to Ben Johnson. Ben has walked twice and scored once. All runners advance, second and third now, with two in the bucket, two spot in the order to Ben Johnson. Called strike at the knees, 0-1. And Lucas Androwski works ahead for the first time today, I believe. The pitch. Look out. Oh, what a great job, though, by catcher Evan Blumfeld.
Clipped him in the foot.
Got him in the hoof. And down to first goes Ben Johnson. HBP, hit by pitch. For those of you scoring along at home with your McGregor scorebook and your number two lead pencil, that's just an HBP. Bases loaded again now for Chase McQuaid. He's the ninth batter to bat this inning for River Falls.
Chase McQuaid has got put the bat on the ball twice, hit the squared it up twice. But two popped, you know,
a fly out to right and a fly out to center for McQuaid today.
But squared both balls up.
Mm-hmm.
A little high though.
I'd say Androsky is going to have to come to him here with the bases loaded. There's no place to put McQuaid.
That was a pitch right there.
Does come to him, takes it. It's 1-1.
But when you've been having some, a little bit of control issues and you're walking some batters, mm-hmm. you know, smart veteran move by McQuaid to take a strike.
The 1-1 pitch, that's flipped up foul and out of play.
He wasn't taking that one.
Hey, Kyle Wright, he's on, and he agrees with us. He said they are the Brewers, Brewers reminiscent. He said, like in the unis. I do, too. I think they're new, Kyle. Welcome aboard, Mr. Kyle Wright. Glad to have you here this afternoon. The rest of the camera units are going to be installed tomorrow, so we're going just base offense today. That yacker is left upstairs. It's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Three in for the Cats here in the bottom of the third. It's 7-1.
Well, there must be a truck out there on Hanson Drive.
Yeah.
The mic's picking that thing up.
Chopper towards second. Gathered, flipped to short. Got him. I went the short way on that. Nice job out there by Owen Blomfelt. The second baseman flips it to his shortstop, Jace Rue. And gets McQuaid on the 4-6 ground out, and that will do it for the Wildcats. Three runs on one hit, no errors, and three left. Three in the books now at First National Bank at River Falls Field. It's 7-1 Wildcats. You know what that sound you hear might be? That might be my lift arriving for to hang the cameras tomorrow. I think it is. I think it is. Nope, it's a school bus for the matinee game, for the evening game.
Oh, okay.
Must be another game after our game. School bus. It's a diesel bus.
Oh, I see a team walking in right now.
Yeah, diesel bus.
Is there a double? Oh, is Superior playing a doubleheader?
Maybe against Hudson?
Yeah, that looks like Hudson.
It does.
Yeah, you know what? Superior. Brian, you ready to take over? I bet Superior, just with the travel time, they're probably trying to get two games in.
Might as well. Yeah. You make the ride down from Superior.
Kevin, I'm gonna go.
All right.
Head over to Menominee.
Greg Peters, thanks again.
I'm gonna give the keys over to Brian McQuaid. Brian, take us on home. Land that plane, all right?
See you, Greg. Thank you. All right. Hey, Brian, one of the beauties of the headset, it keeps your ears warm. We've already deducted that. We got a heater here, too, so you can. It's really warm. Like, put your hand right here.
Yeah.
You can. This is way better than sitting in the stands.
I'm going to be hanging out here.
You should.
I can take this hat off.
You can.
I
got a little glare, but it's not bad.
So because of my hairstyle, I actually I gotta adjust my headset.
Here, just push it down. There you go. There you go. How's that?
That's better. No, I'm better.
You're gonna pull your mic right up to your mouth. Good there.
Go. Well, anyhow, we got.
So okay, now you got the control. So here we go. Dawson Alberg, we're going 3, 4, and 5. And Dawson's on the screen, so we already got the batter correct.
Got to find my spots here. This is my first time.
It is. So it'll take an inning or two to get back in the groove a little bit. Check swing. Let me see the. I'm gonna check the. Can you give me the Wildcat lineup over there? I just want to see that.
Sure.
I just want to take a look.
Yep. There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah, you bet.
Jack Mannanen is on the bump now for River Falls. So he gets a strikeout on Dawson Alberg.
Jack Mannanen. Batting for Superior, first baseman number 33, Hudson Helenius.
Here, let's do this. Let's go to River Falls, edit rosters. And when Jack Mannanen comes up here, where is
right here.
Okay, where it says bench, click on that and just hit pitcher and then hit save.
All right.
That'll put it. There it is, Jack Manningman.
Perfect.
Okay, you're back to there.
All right, I got to get the next batter up here. Can you help me out with that?
Yeah. I think it's over here somewhere, at next at bat.
Oh, there we are.
Yeah.
All right, perfect.
Or just hit plus one or something. It's Hudson Hellenius that's up.
Yep.
Got it.
All right.
Look at your back in the right. River Eddie. It's like riding a bike, Brian.
Oh, just like riding a bike. I get my balls up real. We got two balls, no strikes.
2-0, down low. So, yeah, Jack Manninen is in relief of Auden Pankinen, did a real nice job today.
Yeah, he did. Throws hard.
Real hard. We had him in low 90s.
Is that where you had him at?
Yeah.
Jugs gun?
Jugs gun had him low 90s. So that's the line on Pankinen. He gave up just a one run on two hits. And there's a one-out walk to Hudson Hellenius. He'll get the first, and we'll go to Tanner Leno. So with one down, we go to Tanner Leno. Tanner's in the five spot in the order. He struck out swinging his first time up today against a hard-throwing Auden Pankinen. Jack Manninen in the game now in relief. So how are you, Brian?
I'm pretty good, thanks.
Good. Chopper, left side, and foul. Work's going good?
Yeah, things are good. I'm trying to see. Okay, I can see it on the TV. I'm red, green, colorblind.
Oh, yeah.
So that's I try making sure I have somebody on base. And,
I'm just going to tell you, that's problematic.
for this screen, it is.
Yeah. So you just have to look up there and see if your dots are filled.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at.
It's
yeah,
a strike. So there is a strike you don't have on there. There it is.
It's good to be back.
You're doing
I think
great.
I can lose this jacket too.
It's pretty. It's not like warm up here, but it's comfortable.
I would agree with that.
It's comfortable.
It is definitely comfortable.
0-1. The pitch.
Hello.
One ball, one strike, one out. We're at the five spot in the order. Tanner Leno. Again, Tanner struck out once today. Looking to keep his superior Spartans in this baseball game by finding a way on base. Bat matches the grass today. That one's right there, and it's 1-2. One ball, two strikes, one out, runner at first. Kevin Westhouse, along with Brian McQuaid now in to call it with me the rest of the way. Chopper, right side, going to be a tough play. Manninen bobbles, and he's not going to get him. And that is going to be an E1 on Manninen. Going to be a tough play anyway. Maybe hurried a little bit. Got his glove on it. Couldn't gather it. And now there's runners at first and second with one out. And we go to Lucas Androwski. So Lucas isn't in there because I forgot to put him in. So we could go here to edit roster for Superior. And he'll be batter. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's put him in the 6. Lucas Androwski. You see Lucas down a ways, maybe. I think he's down a ways. Yeah, there he is. So put him over here at the sixth spot. Right there, put a 6 in there, and then hit save.
Okay. Well, you're testing me today. This is all new.
I think that should do it. I don't know. Didn't say
let's see here. We'll see what happens. We'll go next at bat.
I don't know if it came up. It should, but yeah, it did.
Yep,
it did.
There
it
we
worked.
Are.
See? Yeah, you're getting the whole kitchen sink thrown at you early.
Well, for anybody watching, pitch count is not happening.
No, we tried it the first game. We just trust Steve over there. He's done such a nice job.
All right, let me at least get this. We got 3 balls.
3-0. Whew.
Oof. That's a good pitch.
That baby.
Outside corner.
Was a dart. It's 3-1. We'll talk a little bit about your ski trip to Breckenridge, but after you get it hooked into the sink for an inning. Swings through that. It's 3-2. We don't want to have you walking and chewing gum early.
No. I had to get my clicks down.
Yes. The 3-2 pitch, a big one. Oh, that's beautiful. Paints the corner with some cheese. And down goes Androwski, and there's two down. little backwards K in the book there. Two down, and we go to Owen Blomfelt. Owen struck out swinging his first time up. Yeah, Auden Pankinen had seven strikeouts in three innings.
Is that what he had?
Your son had a really nice throw down to second early in the first inning. That was a beautiful throw down.
I actually just caught that.
Yeah, it was beautiful. 0-1 now. On Owen Blomfelt. That's flipped into right. That's going to be trouble. That's down. That might score a run. Here comes a runner. And you're going to hold him at third. Wow. Are you surprised they held him there?
I think I would have sent him.
Maybe, right? It would have took a perfect throw.
But you're down by six.
Right, they held him up at third base. That's a nice single off the bat of Owen Blomfelt, though, into right field, right in front of right fielder Henry Zimmerman. Did a nice job knocking that down. But now the bases are loaded for Evan Blomfelt. With two in the bucket. Nice job by Manninen. Pours that in there. He works ahead, 0-1. That's hit into right center. That's pretty deep. That's trouble. Oh, but the wind knocks it down. Boy, I thought off the bat that was going to be way over the head of the right fielder. The wind just absolutely knocked that thing down, Brian. Yeah, nice job out there by Henry Zimmerman to battle it and make the catch and make the out. I thought that was going to clear the bases. He squared that up, didn't he?
Clear the bases.
I thought he was going to, but not. Henry Zimmerman, he's like, I'm all over that like a pack of dogs on a three-legged cat. He says, I'll take that. And that'll do it for the Superior Spartans here in inning four. They get no runs on the one hit, no errors, and three left after three and a half from First National Bank at River Falls Field. It's your Wildcats 7, the Superior Spartans 1. So Breckenridge, you were up there about a month ago, was that now?
Yeah, about that. We go once a year.
It's good to see you come back when you're not in a sling.
I'm not in a sling.
No broken collarbones this time?
Nope.
Did you venture to the Blacks by the time your vacation ended or not?
Yes. Yep, we did. We did go down Blacks, but I went down slow, so it doesn't matter what I'm going down. I can control your speed, so I wasn't fast.
Just stay off the moguls.
I stayed off of those. I did not go down any of those.
Yeah, the moguls can eat you up.
I really like it out there. It's
nice. It's I lived there for 23 years. It's nice. It's fresh air. It's relaxed people. But shoot the lock off your wallet, though, because it's... You say, how much is it? Yeah. They go, how much you got?
Yeah, exactly right. I love it out there. They have apps now that will track how fast you're going.
Oh, down the hill.
Yeah.
Really?
Nothing that I need because I don't go that fast. But we were at dinner, and my youngest son, he said, Dad, how fast do you think I was going today?
Uh-huh.
I was like, I don't really want to know.
Right.
It was 52.
No way. Like, skiing?
Yeah.
That's fast.
I think he said 52 because he and Chase Rudolph, they're like, so we think we can get it to 60.
No,
I don't. Hey. I don't want you to get to 60.
If you don't,
it might have been faster. It might have been 56. I know it wasn't far off of 60. I'm like, oh my god! But there's a little jump right before, and we slowed down for that. I'm like, oh my.
Hey, if you don't think 50 or 40 is fast, go down the highway at 50, then open the car door and look down.
Exactly. Gosh,
No, you can't. You can't miss on
they
that.
They are.
Right? You got to stay on your feet.
It's fun. They are nuts out there. I'm like, you know, if you fall going that fast, you're gonna get hurt.
Yeah. Nah, skiing is fun in Colorado. How was the snow?
It was good.
Was it good?
You know, the day we left, I think we had about 8 inches overnight, and the Rudolph skied that day, but we were leaving. We left early that morning, so you can't see them. But yeah, how about you? What have you been up to?
Working a lot. This week's been crazy, just busy at work. I left today and I had like 74 emails in my inbox. So I'm supposed to be off tomorrow, but I think I'm going to be sitting quietly getting caught up. So no, it's been busy. I golfed a lot in January. I think I golfed 20 rounds between Florida and Arizona. And then February, March, it's just been work. Nose to the grindstone.
Will you be golfing this year here?
I would like to.
Good.
Caden Mueller is up. So who's 21 for? You have it over there. Who's 21 for Superior? He's pitching.
Lucas Androwski?
Oh, yes, he's still on then. So Lucas Androwski, same as last inning. Starts him out with an old Uncle Charlie. He drops that in there. It's 0-1. So Lucas Androwski came in relief of Andrew Melgeorge, and he's in again to face Caden Mueller in the four spot. Caden is 1-for-1 with a double and a run scored and a walk.
It's two strikes right away.
Now it's 0-2. He works ahead, a four-hole hitter, Caden Mueller.
He had a great hit earlier today.
Oh, really good.
Yeah.
He ripped that down into the corner. It was... We called that one. That was a flush
rocket.
What are
you going to call this one?
That is a little duck snort into left center field. Tape single, leadoff single for Caden Mueller. It'll look like a frozen rope in the morning. And he, more importantly, Brian, he's 2-for-2 today now with a walk, and we go to Henry Zimmerman. It wasn't as pretty as that flush rocket he hit down into the corner, but it really got the job done. He's on. A little back pick and in safely. Ball skirts away from the first baseman, Mr. Hudson Hellenius. We put him right on the honorable mention all names team.
You know what? That's appropriate.
That's a pretty good name. It's not like the best name ever, but it's honorable mention all names team. Only one today.
Is this pitch? Is this a new one? I haven't seen this yet on the board.
And this, I don't know. We put this up last year. This kind of happened through last summer. So you could add one if we haven't got one. This was the other day. We didn't have forgot chin music. So we can add one. We got room. You know, we got plenty of wall space to add some new sayings if we need to. We're talking about we have all the sayings on the wall written up here in permanent marker. About 70 of them. 0-2.
Yeah, there's a lot of them up here.
Yeah, I mean, that ball that was hit earlier, too, by Cade Miller, might have just been walloped.
Walloped. Yeah, check that one off
right,
the list.
Right, I called it a flush rocket, but it might have just been walloped. Oh, where was that? That was a pretty good-looking pitch there off the
sure
arm
was.
Of Lucas Androwski. Called a ball. It's 1-2 now on Henry Zimmerman. Henry has grounded out to short and reached on a fielder's choice and scored a run today. Cody Olson waits on deck for the Wildcats. Nice lead out there by Caden Mueller. He's not going. Pitches down and inside. Now it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Nobody out. Wind whipping off the back of the jersey of Androwski on the mound. It took a little off of that, had Zimmerman out in front, and down he goes swinging. One down.
First baseman number 8, Cody Olson.
Now we go to Cody Olson. Cody is 2-for-2 today.
Yeah, he's doing great.
2-for-2. Boy, we really like that first hit he had. We hit both of them opposite field, but that first one just barreled it up and shot it through over here on the left side between the third baseman and the shortstop. 2-for-2 day. See if he can keep that thing going. Runner go, sort of first. Just go on through.
Oh, dropped it.
And dropped the baseball. I'm going to say that was really well executed, though, by Superior, right? The runner went. Pitcher still just went to first. First baseman just drove towards second base, threw the ball to the shortstop, and Caden Mueller, his kid, just kicked it out of his glove. So he'll get down to second base. Ooh, absolute backyard whiffler right there.
I see, that was the one I was looking at. It's like, when? How are you going to get that in there? Nicely done.
The 0-1 tries to come breaker again. That one's off the plate, 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out. The pitch fouled straight back to the screen. It's 1-2. Nice job by Androwski working ahead of the hitters this inning. Up to this point, Superior's been working from behind quite often, but this inning, Lucas Androwski decides to come out and work ahead of the hitters, doing a really nice job ahead of Cody Olson, 1-2 now. Let's see if he comes back and tries to break one off on him here. He does. And Olson flips it up. left side. Third baseman giving chase. He's camped under it and makes the catch in foul territory. And Olson fouls out, and there are two down to the third baseman. We're going to Ty Menenden, designated hitter. Ty is one for one with a double and a walk and a run scored. And trying to pick him off. No sale there. Caden Mueller alertly back to the bag. Yeah, the heater isn't like blasting heat, but it's taking the edge off in the press box.
I agree. Just the not being in the wind.
Right. Yeah, the thermometer said upper 40s, but it felt like upper 30s because of the wind. And up here, it feels like 50 with no wind. One ball, no strikes. Two in the bucket. There's a runner out there at second base for Menenden. See if he can get Caden Mueller in with two in the bucket. That's just down. Now 2-0. Should Ty Menenden reach, Chase Rudolph waits on deck for the Cats. Androwski set the pitch. That's called a strike at the knees. Ty Menenden kind of side-eyed the umpire there, but it's a strike. It's 2-1.
That didn't look much different than the last one.
Yeah, no. Looked a little down maybe, but umpire says that's at the knees. It's a strike. 2-1. The pitch. Back ankle breaker there. Gets him to swing through that. It's 2-2. Now the twos are wild. At two balls, two strikes, and two outs with a runner at second base for the River Falls Wildcats. Still a chance here for Ty Menenden to get himself a two-out ribby. The pitch. Ball squirts away from the catcher and alertly on down to third base goes Caden Mueller. Boy, I tell you what, Evan Blomfelt behind the dish here for Superior. He's working his buns off tonight, isn't he?
He has been. I was actually talking about that earlier with Jeff Feiereisen.
Yeah, how hard he's working back there? He's working hard. Yeah. The full count pitch. Chopped foul, then we'll do it again. Two in the bucket. It's Ty Menenden trying to keep this inning going. Maybe squirt one through here and plate another one for River Falls. 7-1. We're in the bottom of inning four, halfway mark of this contest. There it is, grounder, shortstop, in deep in the hole. It's going to be a long throw across. Wow. Got him by a step. Boy, that's a solid play out
that
there by
really
shortstop. Jace Rue getting it done on Ty Menenden. 6-3 put out for the third out of the inning. Wildcats get no runs on the one hit. No errors and one left. Four in the books now from First National Bank of River Falls Field. It's your Wildcats 7, the Superior Spartans nothing.
All right, top of five.
Top of inning five. How you doing over there? You kind of getting back in the groove a little bit?
You know what? It's coming back.
Good.
It's coming back a little bit. It's slow, but it's coming back.
Good.
You don't get a break from this stuff.
Not much. I got like a week, and then softball came, and they said they want to start doing softball. So I looked at the checkbook for our River Falls Sports Broadcasting, our nonprofit. I'm like, I think I have enough in there to buy another set. So I went out and bought a whole other set of gear for softball.
Really?
So I had to put all that together, load all the new software, get all the right connectors. I think I got that going for those folks too. So in my little spare time, I can get another set up. So I'll be doing girls soccer, which will be on tonight. We got boys baseball, of course. Now we've got girls softball as well going on this spring on the River Falls Sports Broadcasting Network.
Good for you.
How about that? We'll keep expanding it.
What's going on with cameras then here?
So tomorrow morning, I'm getting my cameras installed. So we'll have one here.
So this one's out.
So that one in the center field one's out. And then That one that was on that post over there, that one went to the Hockey Association because I got them going this year.
Oh, is that where it went? Okay.
Yeah, so then I got a new one that's coming up there, and that's this are all going to be installed.
That's all on tomorrow. A toggle then.
It's all here on joystick. Yes. So that'll be coming in tomorrow morning. I've got a guy coming in tomorrow morning to put those in. So
what do we got for a batter here?
Like you said, no rest for the wicked. It's Tucker Fraser, nine-hole hitter, chopper to short third, Chase. Gathered on the first, got him. Nice job by Chase Rudolph. One pitch, one out. Tucker Frazier grounds out to third, 5-3, one out. So I am taking a vacation day tomorrow, but
doesn't sound like it.
Then I'll be
catch up on your emails.
And installing cameras. And then Saturday morning, so I'll get the cameras physically installed tomorrow. I'll finish the story after they're back to the top of the order to Calvin Anderson. So tomorrow they physically get installed. Then I've got my computer guy coming in because they're all called IP cameras.
Yeah.
So I got had those cameras talking to this router here, then talking to the joystick. And so I've got my computer guy coming in that knows IP addresses guy. So he's going to set them all up so they'll work with the joystick and the computer.
Oh, my God.
So then I do that Saturday morning for a couple hours. So it's always something. I don't know if I'm. Then I'm going to Saturday afternoon. I'm going to help softball get going.
Oh, are you?
Yes.
Where's that at? At the high school here.
Yeah.
Right. They don't. Do they ever play here?
They do once. Okay. They have. I've done a couple softball games here, which have been very fun, by the way. Ariel Vestrez, welcome aboard, Ariel. Miss you, friend. We had such a great time doing basketball together this year. Ariel and his wife Debbie. Solid broadcasts, color commentators. Guy comes prepared every game. It's good. Miss Ariel. Three balls and two strikes now on Kelvin Anderson. Kelvin is 2-for-2 today. He hasn't hit a ball a combined like 150 feet. He's got two hits. First one he dropped in over the head of the shortstop. Then he had a swinging bunt. It was perfect out in front of the plate. He's 2-for-2, and he'll stay at 2-for-2 as he gets a walk right there. So Calvin Anderson is on with one out. We go to Jace Rue. Jace has been a strikeout victim swinging twice today. That's hit to right pretty well. Zimmerman cruises over and makes the catch. Nice job out there by Henry Zimmerman. Filling his position really well today, Brian.
Yeah, he's doing a great job.
That's just a line out to right, two down. Now we go to Dawson Alborg. Peyton Williams pinch hitting for Dawson Alborg. Peyton Williams, if you want to go try to figure that out. He's at three spot if you want to do that. If you put a three next to Peyton's name, that should populate. He's probably down a ways because he's at, was there a sub? Peyton Williams.
Yeah,
let's put a three over there, and that'll do it. Hit enter or save. Looks at a strike, 1-1. Nice job on the mound by Jack Manninen. One ball, one strike to Peyton Williams. Snap, back pick by Chase McQuaid, throwing the rock, snapping it around. Better keep your eyes open for that kid's arm right there. He's got one caught stealing today already. Really nice throw down to second base. A couple back pick attempts, just making sure the guys are paying attention. Little inside pitch. We call that an excuse me swing. Like thinking, nah, I'm not going to then. Uh-oh, that thing is going to hit the inside corner. And it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The pitch tries to break one off on him. No sale. Now the count works full. With two outs, the runner should be going here now. That's Calvin Anderson at first. The dugout will be screaming, wait till he delivers. And then it should be off to the races for Calvin Anderson. There he goes, the pitch. Strike three looking, and Peyton Williams knew it. That was an absolute aspirin off the arm of Jack Manninen, and that will do it for the Superior Spartans here in the top of the fifth. They do send four to the plate, but they get no runs on no hits, no errors, and one left. 4.5 in the books. It's still 7-1, Wildcats.
All right, who we got up next?
We're going to go Chase Rudolph. Yes.
Okay. Great.
Chase Rudolph. So have you hit the golf course yet this spring in some of this nice weather or not?
I have not. I've not played at all. I need some new clubs.
Yeah, do you?
I do.
I do too. I just don't get any.
Do you have a recommendation?
No. You know what? I was lamenting this with my friends in Arizona when I had the medalist round, by the way. I said, by the way, I don't know if you guys remember, you were with me, both of you, my friends, when on my 30th birthday when I got this set of clubs. So I've had them ever since.
Really?
Yeah. And I said, I'm still beating you with them.
I've heard the technology's changed a little bit.
I should get a new set.
I think I want to be a part of it now. Mine are not that old, but mine are quite old. But, I played simulator golf with a friend, and he had brought my bag down. We went to Trayburn, he's like, "What is in your bag?" He's like, "You're playing out of mind today. You are not using those clubs."
So what's different about the new clubs? Is it the?
I think they're just more forgiving.
Are they?
Yeah, and I used to be stronger, so I could swing the club a little harder. I don't know if I could flex a shaft anymore. So mine are pretty stiff, but yeah, I'm just ready for a change. I'm due.
I could be talked into that. I don't even know what does a new set of clubs even go for today. Like, you'll get a nice set. Are they a couple grand? I have no idea.
So you're probably looking at for irons $200 a club. But a lot of them now it's five through wedge. Everything is de-lofted, you know. So it's, I don't know. It's you're gonna pick up some distance for sure.
Yeah. Well, if it's $200 a club, you know, if it's like my last set I have that I still have after 25 years, I might get my money's worth.
Your cost per use is
it's pretty low. It's not a big deal at that point. Be a decent value. I think I could justify that.
I think you could too.
All right, Chase Rudolph, but is this a pinch hitter, I believe? No, it is Chase Rudolph.
He's playing third.
Sorry, yep. So Chase Rudolph, he lined out to center today and he walked. Third time at the plate for eight-hole hitter Chase Rudolph. This is number four for Superior on the mound. This is still the same fella. Yes, it is. It's still, I was looking over here on your score sheet to your right.
Lucas
Andreski is still in there. Yep.
No.
It's not. Who is
it? See, that's what we need.
Let's look right on the sheet here. Hudson. It's four.
Hudson.
Oh, no, it's four. Hudson Helanius.
Yeah.
Is pitching.
Let me get that adjusted.
So Hudson Helanius is on the mound.
Good catch.
So he just got where it says bench there. Just hit pitcher and then hit save next to his name.
Find him.
He's towards the top, I think.
Was he?
Yeah, because he was a starter. There he is. Right here. So where's his bench? Hit pitcher.
There we go.
And hit save. There he is. All right.
All right.
Hudson Helanius. It says four. His number's four. Oh, it is. I'm looking at. Okay, you're right. Number four. It's
right here,
this guy.
Yep.
Tucker Frazier.
Gosh.
Sorry.
There's nobody better than Steve.
That's why we got him here.
Right.
Batting now, center fielder number 13, Bryce Bevin.
All right, I'm going to
catch up. We'll get you. It's a walk for Rudolph. We go to Bryce Bevin now, nine spot in the order.
All right, let's get.
We're having a nice chat. They're sneaking players in on us. Guys.
All right, there we go.
Tucker, Frazier, Bartholomew, it's a good thing you don't try to put the names on their back because that is not going to fit. that is not going to fit.
Abbreviate. Initials.
TFB. I mean, seriously, that would be like 20 letters.
We got to get Bryce's name updated here, too. Yeah. It's too many E's.
Yeah, Tucker, Frazier, Bartholomew.
It's a good block.
Throw down, safe, stolen base for Chase Rudolph. Yeah, I mean, you have to put that like at a three font. You couldn't see it. It's a long name. So Bryce Bevin now with an RBI opportunity with nobody out. Count is even at 1-1. It just finds the corner. Nice pitch there by TFB, Tucker Frazier. By the time I get his name out, it's like the next pitch. I'm not saying it's long, but a little check swing, fouled, and he'll live for another one. We'll stick at 1-2. Hey, Craig Finstad, welcome aboard. Ariel, I like the above the basket cam for basketball. I think we could do that. I saw some of that in the NCAA tournament as well and had the similar thought. Little skew shot, right side. Second baseman gathers it on to first. Got him by a step. Once again, nice job over there by Owen Blomfeldt for Superior, playing his position well. Gets Bryce Bevin on the 4-3 ground out, one out. With that, Chase Rudolph gets over to third. Now it's a runner at third with less than two outs. Set up pretty good for the top of the order for the Wildcats in Austin Curdy. Austin looking for his first hit. He's reached on an error. He's walked and scored, and he's grounded out to second twice today. That ball kicks away from the catcher. Here comes the runner, and he'll score. So Rudolph scores on a pass ball. Wildcats get to the eighth spot. You're going to give that a wild pitch, says the official scorer. I'll put a WP down next to him there, and that'll clear the bases now for Austin Curdy.
Boy, I'm loving his gloves. Look at those.
Oh, the farm gloves or what? What's he got on there? Just yellow. Just yellow, I think. Looks like some Wrangler gloves. Like you could thread some barbed wire with those. Twist some barbed wire down. 3-0 on Austin Curdy. I think there was a kid in the Little League World Series. He came in with the farm gloves and hit a dinger.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I saw a highlight of that the other day, actually. Chopper, right side. Second baseman again on two hops, and that's going to skirt by him on into right field. Let's see. E4, we're going to call that. Under the glove of second baseman Owen Blomfeldt.
Batting now, second baseman number 5, Ben Johnson.
So now we're going to go to Ben Johnson with one in the bucket and a runner at first. Runner out to his four-step lead. The pitch. That's hit. Left side. Left fielder cruising over in the gap, still battling the wind. Now the center fielder calls for it and makes the catch. Hey, nice job out there by center fielder Tanner Leno to call off his left fielder, who had a better angle on that. Then gets Ben Johnson on the fly out to center for two down. And now we're going to go to Chase McQuaid.
He did a great job just even shadowing the sun a little bit. I mean, mm-hmm. He's looking right back into the sun.
Mm-hmm.
Great job.
Really good. Wind is whipping around. Now we go to Chase McQuaid with two outs. See if he can find a gap here. Swings through that little off-speed pitch. It's 0-1. Chase McQuaid has flown out to right, flown out to center, and grounded out to second today. He has hit the ball hard three times. Hasn't been rewarded for it yet. How about now? Another little slurve. It's 0-2.
I don't think he wanted that one.
Sweeper, they call that. Sweeper pitch, the 0-2. That's hammered in the left. Left fielder going back. He is not going to get that one. That one hops the St. Croix gas sign. Here comes a runner around third. He's being waved home. McQuaid into second base with an RBI two-out double. Chase McQuaid absolutely walloped into deep left field. And McQuaid gets himself a two-out RBI stand-up double.
Betting now, shortstop number 6, Keaton Mueller.
In a non-windy day, that would have a chance to get out of here. But today, they're right into the teeth of the wind, if the wind had teeth. And it's just a double. Now we go to Caden Mueller. Well-struck baseball.
Sure was.
A Hey, Principal Kit Litke, welcome aboard. Yeah, it is a great day for baseball, a great day for Wildcat baseball out here at First National Bank of River Falls Field. Glad you could tune in this afternoon. 9-1 Wildcats now after the big two-out double off the bat of Chase McQuaid. 59-footer hops in there. Good block by Evan Blomfeld of the Superior Spartans, and the count is even at 1-1 with two in the bucket. Still a good opportunity here for Caden Miller with two outs. He's got two hits today. He's 2-for-2 with a walk. Caden Mueller looking to add to that here. Someone sneezed down there. Bless you.
It was an aggressive sneeze.
That was very aggressive. I was going to call it a violent sneeze. I've had a few of those. Whew, little frisbee he threw in there, and it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two out, runner at second, two in for the Wildcats here in the fifth. They lead 9-1. The pitch. Yacker fouled up, out of play. That is going to reach the seats. Nice little crowd here on a brisk afternoon. It's not cold, but it's brisk.
And the sun, it's not
Sun's
bad.
Sun's out. The wind has died out.
I was just going to say that. The wind is what's nippy.
The wind is changing directions a little bit. It was a little more out of the north earlier. Now it's kind of out of the west, blowing out towards right. The pitch. Check swing. Excuse me, swing. Right side. That's going to be a tough play if it stays fair, and it rolls foul. Tell you what, Caden Mueller almost got his third hit of the game there. A little excuse me swing. A little check swinger, but it just rolls foul. Nice job by that pitcher alertly just letting that matriculate just foul.
You got on base last game with that same thing. Same thing.
Kid's churning butter, man. He's into it right now. It's hot. The pitch. That catcher's going to be stiff tomorrow, especially if this is like one of his first games this season. He is working back there.
Boy, I wonder if Superior has snow on the ground yet.
Well, we were talking about that, and we heard there was snow up there earlier this week or last week, so I'm imagining, yes. There wasn't, though, for most of the winter, but just recently, yes, I believe. So a two-out walk now to Caden Mueller. Now we go to Henry Zimmerman with runners at first and second. Henry brought his fan club today. Henry grounded out to short, reached on a fielder's choice and scored and struck out. Looks at a ball. It's one ball and no strikes. That one's there, 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs. So I think Superior is going to be playing a doubleheader today. Is that Hudson that came in?
Yep, Hudson.
So Hudson will be playing Superior after this one. That'll not be broadcast. I'll be home eating leftover tacos.
Is that you're having tonight?
Yeah, I had some last night, and I got home late, and I think they were so good, I think I could go for a couple more of those. Kind of in the mood for hard shell, too. Sometimes I like the soft shell, but you a hard shell guy or soft shell
soft
guy?
Soft shell.
Wrap it up like
flour.
A flour. Right? Flour. Wrap it up like a tight burrito.
Flour, soft shell.
Mm-hmm. I went hard shell last night. I could go hard shell again tonight, I think. The pitch. That's hammered towards short. Gathered. Go to flip it to second. Nice job out there by shortstop. Let me see. Hold on. Let me put my glasses back. Jace Rue making nice plays there for Superior. So Zimmerman grounds out to short for the second time today, and that will do it for the Wildcats here in inning five. They get two runs on one error, one left, and what did I say, one hit. After five complete, it's the Wildcats 9, Superior 1. There. I didn't hear what he was asking.
You want to know if he could hang their camera on the net?
Oh, yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Yeah. Nice of him to ask.
Yes. If you really want to get caught up, so we've got, they've got two errors. We have one error. More errors. I should put my glass on. Hoping for that.
Oh, here they are. All right. So Superior has how many?
They have two, and we have one.
Okay. There we go.
Now we're all.
They have two though, right?
Yeah, they have
three.
Two. No,
I put one too many up. There we are.
So Hudson Elanius is up now. Hudson has grounded out to third and walked today. Here we go. Top of inning six. Jack Mannanen back on the mound for River Falls. Just missed there. Ball one. Whew. Good velo on that, huh? Good velocity.
And what would you put that on the jugs gun?
That had 86. Yeah, one ball, one strike. Tries to put a little wrinkle on that. Misses. It's 2-1. Hey, Scott, man. He's still tuned in. Hit to third. Nice play. Gathered. On to first. Got him. Hey, nice play over there, Mr. Rudolph. In the chase, Rudolph gets Hudson Hellenius on a 5-3 round out. There's one down, and we're going to go to Tanner Leno.
That was a great play.
Real nice. We're at the 5 spot in the order. Center fielder Tanner Leno. He struck out, and he's reached on an error. Last time up, he hit one towards first base, and Jack Mannanen just couldn't pick it up. He did and bobbled it. Two and oh. High chopper, left side. Gonna be a tough play. Gathers it, throws the body.
Got it.
Got him a half a step. Oh, what a play. Caden Mueller threw an absolute seed across the infield and got the speedy Tanner Leno by half a step. Nice play, huh, Brian?
That was a really nice play. I think it was a great play even with Chase Rudolph. He noticed that Caden was coming in on it because they were both moving on that ball.
Yes.
He held up and...
Boy, that thing was a high chopper. You got to get that out of your glove quick and then just throw a strike.
Another one. Right back at him.
That one's going to be a little easier. Throws it high, but nice job over there by Cody Olson staying on the bag and back-to-back ground outs to short, and that will do it quickly for the Spear Spartans here in the top of the sixth. They send three to the plate, Brian. They get no runs on no hits. There were no errors and none left. 5.5 in the books. It's still 9-1. Cats.
Who do we have up?
We're going to go
Zim or Olson.
Olson, Mannanen, okay. And Rudolph. Right. 6, 7, 8 do up for River Falls here in the bottom of frame 6. Right. If you're looking ahead for the River Falls Wildcats.
All right. We still have Tucker on the mound.
Tucker, Fraser. I think it's Bartholomew. I have B-E-R-T-H dot, dot, dot.
Yeah, right.
It didn't even fit on the score sheet.
If you can't get it on the score sheet, you're definitely
not getting it on your jersey.
You're not getting it on your jersey.
No. Like, I'd feel very sorry for the kid, like in kindergarten. Like, you got to spell your name, you know. Bill Smith, you know, on one side of you, and you got Jill Jones on the other side of you. And here you are at 5 years old having to throw down Tucker, Fraser, Bartholomew. Come on, give the 5-year-old a break already. Good for him, though, right?
I mean,
if he can figure that out, he's going to be well on his way to being a Rhodes Scholar.
All
tough love, they call that. Like, come on, kids, spell it. Like, I thought his head to know my address. 526 3rd Street. Spell your name, son. He had to get the 64 box of crayons because he wore 25 of them out writing his name down. Working that sharpener. I'm not saying I sharpened a lot of crayons in the back of my box, but I went through those built-in sharpeners on the back. Were you one of those kids who had this box of 64 with a built-in sharpener? Were you that kid?
I was not that kid, but I know those kids.
Right? Were they the envy of the classroom or what?
Yes.
Yeah. Cody Olson's up now. Cody's 2 for 3. Yeah, we got a pinch hitter, number one.
Oh, boy.
So that is Tyler Nelson is in. Thank you. We're over here telling crayon jokes. Tyler Nelson is batting now.
Tyler.
Hammered foul. And Jack Mannanen's on deck for Tyler Mannanen. But yeah, I think Randy Winterhack, he had the 64 box, and Margaret Hooley. Like, I can remember that from the second grade. And they wouldn't share either. Hammered to third. Nice play over there at third base. They're all the way across. Got him. Well-struck ball there by Tyler Nelson, but a better play at third base by Calvin Anderson. And that will do it for Nelson.
Number four, Jack Mannanen.
So one down. We go to Jack Mannanen. Right.
Well, I didn't get to the last one.
So Jack Mannanen's in now with one down.
All right. I've had Ty up, his brother.
I think I got the 8 box, right? That's on the sheet, you know. One's trapper. What do they call that thing? A trapper keeper? I got one trapper keeper and an 8 box of crayons and a blunt nose scissors. I just got what was on the sheet. Mom and Dad are like, no, no, put that box of 64 down. That thing is $1.80. You're not getting that. You don't need that. The teacher said the 8 box.
There's a sharpener in the classroom. You don't need it on the box.
Borrow Randy's sharpener. He's got one built in. Yeah. He wouldn't let me near his desk. Get away. Maybe charge me a nickel for that or something back in the day.
That was a good pitch.
2 balls and 2 strikes now on Jack Mannanen. Pinch hitting for Ty Mannanen. The 2-2 fouled away. Good hack there. Fouled up, out of play. So I've got my on-field mic. It was so windy. It was picking up wind noise. So Greg put it in a bucket over here.
It's still picking up wind noise.
It is a little bit. The wind changed a little bit. It's not as bad as it was, though. You can't hear the bat noise very good today, but it's just too windy to have that mic out there. All right, 3-2 on Jack Mannanen. Mannanen went up with one out here in the bottom of inning 6. Some activity in the Wildcat bullpen. I bet we get a new chucker in the 7th. We'll have to wait and see. The pitch, 59.5 footer, and Jack Mannanen garners himself a one out free pass, and we're going to go to Chase Rudolph.
Batting now is third baseman number 2, Chase Rudolph.
Not before the proverbial conference on the mound. Looks like a hockey line change, doesn't it? There are people going everywhere. I think we have a new chucker, number 7 for Superior. Who's 7 over there?
Number 7, Dawson. Dawson Alberg.
Dawson Alberg gets the rock. He was playing left. Yeah, so Dawson Alberg now chucking.
All right, got him updated. So we had a fire in our driveway.
Tell me more.
Saturday.
Tell me more. What happened?
Well, so I had this hat on that I have in my hands, stocking hat.
Mm-hmm.
And it smelled like smoke, so my wife washed it. And it fit a lot better before.
Really? So what happened? That was in the fire?
Shrunk up when she washed it. It's tight now.
Jeez. Well, it won't blow off in the wind.
It would definitely not blow off. I'm afraid it might pop off.
So someone's asking us online, how many hits does River Falls have? So what do we have? I think it says... Six on the board, so we got to go up.
We'll update that.
It just says four there. We have six, actually. So we'll update that for you at home on our scoreboard.
Once I find it. Yeah. Here we are. What are we at first?
Hey, there you go, CM. And for they've got three.
All right, let's get one added for them.
Yeah.
Getting there.
So you have Dawson Alberg.
Yep, I got that change, but hits. Hits.
That's fine. We're
good.
It's
a work in progress.
I like the question though, CM.
Yeah, it was a nice one.
They sensed it was wrong. It was only off by a couple.
There's a lot of clicks here.
A lot of clicking. Yeah, on your screen at home, looks like a nice summer day, doesn't it?
It does look nice, doesn't it?
That grass is taking well here early in April.
Now pitching for Superior,
it's
number seven, Dawson Alborg.
So Dawson Alborg is in. Chase Rudolph. Chase lined out to center. He's walked twice and scored once. Scored on a wild pitch his last time up. Looks at a ball.
So any adjustments to the cameras you're making this year then?
No, and there's going to be a new one over here. One I had there, it was great to give that enclosure to the Hockey Association because it was leaking water and we couldn't figure out why.
Yeah, I remember it had water in it.
Yeah, it did. So I got a new one of those, and then that one, it's inside the hockey rink, so I don't have a water issue.
Right.
So that will work great. The heater's in it and all that. So. Other than that, no. I know. Do all my preset shots and stuff. It'll be fun to get that going. We're just on base offense right now.
Just even having the
center field shots.
Yeah, the center field
shots. It's nice. We can zip around, though, not looking through the nets, get the good pickoff and delivery shots. So it'll be, we'll upgrade it by next week.
Four pitch walk
to Chase Rudolph. Now we go to the
Wildcats is number three, Colton Maves.
Oh.
Colton Maves, nine-hole hitter.
Yeah, I have to.
Should be in there. I think I added them all yesterday. He's probably down there.
Yeah, let's get it.
So Colton Maves is in now with two on and one out. Looks at a strike. It's 0-1. And that'd be in the nine spot in the order. You see him in there or no? Swings through that, it's 0-2.
There he is.
Soldier's way down there. Nine. Niner.
All right, there he is.
He'll be happy.
What are we at here? 0-2?
Yes. Look out, that's upstairs now, 1-2. Grandma will be happy.
Yep.
You're right? Get the kid's name on there. CM says, hey, thank you for updating the hits.
Thanks awesome. For reminding us.
Yes. Keep us. Oh, that is filthy. That yacker drops in there, and Colton Maves could go. Whew, that was filthy. Not much argument from Colton, and Dawson Alberg drops in a deuce on him, and there's two outs now. We'll go back to the top of the order to Austin Curdy. With two on and two out. Once again, Alberg wrinkles that, finds the outside corner. It's 0-1.
He's a tall kid, isn't he?
Very tall. 6'4 variety, maybe, huh?
Yeah, maybe.
1-1. Austin Curdy walked in the first and scored, grounded out to second twice, and then reached on an error and scored his last time up. High chopper, right side, and that's foul.
find out how JV did.
Yeah, find that out. Beano playing over there?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a little protractor opposite way and foul. Nice job there by Austin Carty flipping that the other way. Trying to get some Oppo tacos on that, speaking of tacos, and just foul.
Is that a hard shell or a soft shell?
Yeah, hard to me. Okay. Yeah, yeah. There's some nights I'm just like, all I want is a soft shell, but not the last 2 days, hard shell. 2-2. Twos are wild again. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, two on. In the bottom of the sixth, scoreboard's correct. It's 9-1 River Falls over the Superior Spartans. Away, the count's full. Now the runners will be off to the races here with two outs. They'll make sure that pitcher delivers, and off they'll go. Let's see if Curdy can shoot one in the gap here and get a couple more in. Runners go. That is hit hard through. One run is in. Other runner chucking to third.
It got by him.
It did. He popped.
Oh, but he stopped.
He stopped.
Yeah.
I think if you score him there, he's game over because that would have been 10 runs.
Yeah, you're right. I wonder if he held him up.
On purpose.
Yeah.
On purpose. He does get to second on a little bit of a bobble. Run scores. Runners at second and third now, and we go to the two-hole hitter, Ben Johnson. That ball was hit hard.
It was.
And the right fielder bobbled. They might have been able to score Rudolph from third, but head coach Ryan Bishop says, no, not right now. Inside, ball one to Ben Johnson. Ben walked in the first inning and scored. He walked in the second inning. He was hit by a pitch in the third inning. So he was on base three times, and he flew out to center his last time up. Officially 0 for 1 today. Flipped up, fouling out of play, and it's 1-1. Couple runners there for River Falls. The pitch. Flown up on the infield. Second baseman battling the sun and calling and makes the catch out in short right field. And that will do it for the Wildcats here in the bottom of inning six. And we'll go to the top of the seventh after that fly out to second by Ben Johnson. So I'll give you a little recap here after I mark my scorebook. F4, three outs. They get one run on the one hit, no errors, and two left. Six in the books now from First National Bank at River Falls Field. It's 10-1 Wildcats. We're going to top of inning seven, and a new pitcher, number 18, Ethan Jeffers. Ethan Jeffers. I do not remember typing that name in there, but
let's see.
I see if I did.
Is
he in there?
He's dual rostered, JV varsity.
So I don't know. I put a whole bunch in there yesterday, so we'll see if I got him. He'd be down. Remember, he's number 18. Yep.
There he is.
There he is, yep. Ethan Jeffers.
Put him in. Pitcher,
Ethan Jeffers. Ethan Jeffers, he is a sophomore.
He's a sophomore, yep. Throws hard.
We'll take a look at him here. John Fry says, I'm scoring at home. That's nice. Gets a McGregor scorebook and the number 2 lead pencil, John. It's always fun to score along. Good little keepsake for yourself. Keep them in the book. Discuss it with the kiddos later on. I like to review those things. You never know. John Fry, Mr. Evansville Wrestling YouTube guru. He's good. He's really good. The Evansville folks got something going on with the wrestling.
Ethan Jeffers. Leading off the top of the seventh inning, the Superior Spartan. Second baseman, number 2, Owen Blomfelt.
Owen Blomfelt is in for Superior. A little tougher for the batters now. We got sun shade going on between the pitcher's mound and home plate. Last chance here for Superior, down a nine spot against the sophomore, Ethan Jeffers. Called a strike. Ethan Jeffers, that's a pretty good name for a pitcher, too, isn't it?
I agree.
Ethan Jeffers. Just sounds like he's like he means business. The sophomore Jeffers kicks and delivers, paints the corner. It's 0-2. The coach said, go in and throw strikes, son. And he says, all right. It's 0-2 now. On Owen Blomfeld. Owen is 1-for-2 today. The 0-2 pitch. Here it comes. Got him right in the beef. Yeah, too bad. He had him 0-2 and maybe tried to find the inside corner, and he hit him. So Owen Blomfeld reaches. Now we go to Evan Blomfeld after that HBP hit by pitch. We're at the eighth spot in the order for Superior. Evan has walked and scored, and he's scored the only run today for Superior, and he's flew out to right. Another strike. He's thrown really three nice, really nice strikes,
yes,
and then one beanball.
A little bit of a crowd developing here as we're.
Yes.
Need, some Hudson people moving in.
John Fry said down in Evansville near Madison, it's cloudy down here. He said the snow melted today, though.
It's good.
Yeah, they got some snow down in southern Wisconsin.
I was talking to someone this week, and they said that they were driving back from that area, and there was a lot of snow, and
yeah,
missed us somehow. We must have been the donut hole, huh?
We didn't get anything. We barely got a skiff here.
I know my parents up in Spooner said that they had snow on the ground. They were down here for Monday's game.
Check the runner.
And
they had snow?
They have, yeah, snow on the ground.
Yeah, we're in the donut hole here.
We are.
Nothing. Like I said, hey, this grass took well through the winter. Got a fresh mow on it.
Yeah, I
see
that.
You got striping going on already. Got it laid down perfect. That's high and tight. Little chin music. It's 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Waves the bat, chokes up a half inch. The pitch. Oh, filthy breaker. Doesn't get him to offer at it. It's 2-2. Pretty good movement on that pitch from the sophomore. Ethan Jeffers.
He throws hard.
He does.
He throws hard.
Pitcher set at the belt. And here it comes. Couldn't pull the shutter on that. Left it up high and tight. It's 3-2. Jeffers checks the runner, has the sign. The full count pitch, here it comes. Just missed. High and tight, and two on, nobody out, and Superior trying to extend this game any way they can. They know the last three outs are always the toughest to get.
Stepping up to the plate, pitcher number 7, Dawson Alborg.
So,
how am I off here?
Yeah, because it's a pinch hitter.
Oh, did you say pinch? I didn't hear him say that. All right.
Yeah. Pinch hitter for Tucker Frazier Berth. It's Aldorf.
Pinch hitting, nope. Number 10, Cameron Laporte.
Cameron Laporte is pinch hitting. He might be in there.
I'm looking.
Laporte to third. Step on third. Triple play maybe to second for two. And no, can't throw it around the horn. That is the perfect triple play setup there if you can whip that around. That would have been outstanding. But they get the double play. Nice job by third baseman Chase Rudolph stepping on a sack over there at third, flipping it to second for the second out. It's just a double play, but that's a big twin spin there. And that'll be two down now.
Third baseman number 26, Calvin Anderson.
6-4.
Well, I was in the midst of trying to change that batter's name.
Right.
I missed it.
It was quick, one pitch hitting. So there's two down, and he reaches to first, and now we go back to the top of the order to Calvin Anderson. Calvin is 2 for 2 with a walk. Nice job in the leadoff spot today for Calvin. Two in the bucket, just like that. Check swing foul.
Okay.
Look out! Scattered him in his own dugout. Watch your liver over there. Yeah, that's the perfect triple play setup. You got first and second, nobody out, and the third baseman's kind of playing even with a bag over there. He says, if he hits me one hard, I'm just going to step on the bag and flip it around for the three spot, but not quite.
Oh, got him.
Nice yacker by Ethan Jeffers to get the strikeout looking on Calvin Anderson. And that will do it for the River Falls Wildcats in the second game of the season. They're going to even up their record at one apiece with a final score of 10-1.
Yeah,
so when you're done, if you just hit ball game here, it'll give a final.
That's what I was looking for.
So there you go. Wildcats today behind the arms of Auden Pankinen, Jack Mannanen, and Ethan Jeffers combined for the 10-1 win today at First National Bank of River Falls Field, and that'll even up their season record at one apiece. Nice game today.
Yeah, it's fun.
Good defense. The Wildcats end up with 10 runs on 7 hits. They did have an error. The Superior Spartans had 1 run on 3 hits and 2 errors. Game time. 2 hours and 7 minutes. Not too bad.
Not too bad at all.
Not too bad at all here on a brisk but decent afternoon from River Falls, Wisconsin. Well, we'll be back with you tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock when the Wildcats will take on the Tartan Titans here, a makeup game from last Tuesday. That'll happen here at 4 o'clock. That'll also happen right here on the River Falls YouTube Sports Broadcasting Network. I'll have to go home tonight after my tacos and schedule that.
Hard shells.
I'm going to schedule that. I haven't scheduled that yet. So that will happen tonight at some point in time after I settle in. I haven't been home since 6:30 this morning. So I'll do a home tonight and do that. Well, I'll tell you what, on behalf of head coach Ryan Bishop, my great color commentator, Mr. Brian McQuaid, I'm Kevin Westhouse saying thanks again for joining us, everybody, and hope you enjoyed the River Falls Wildcats 10-1 win today over the Superior Spartans. Until next time, good night, everyone.